just continue then with our discussion, and we'll get into the seasons now, why the Earth has seasons, and we'll see pretty quickly then the answers to question 43 and 36. So the first thing about the seasons that you have to understand is it will sort of drill down a little bit now, and just look at the orbit of the good old Earth, so the planet that we're on. So what you would do if you're going to do this, and again, this is not to scale, but it's about the best you can do sort of in the drawing mode like this, is you draw some sort of big circle like that, and of course you'd put the sun in the center here, and there's the big glowing hot sun, gives us all of energy. And the first thing that you would maybe do or not do, I'll make this very clear, is you go ahead and draw the Earth in its orbit like this. So here's the blue Earth sort of going around, and we can indicate an arrow like this indicating the Earth's counterclockwise rotation as we've seen. But now the issue is like, well, where do I draw the axes of the Earth, the thing that it spins around? So if you were going to draw the axes like this and place the Earth in its orbit like that, and we're assuming that the Earth is spinning around its axis like that, this is not right, okay? You would not put the Earth in its orbit like that. That is just not the right thing to do. So we definitely need to get rid of this because it's just wrong. So sorry about that. That's not the way the picture would look. We have to do a little better job than that if we want to understand the seasons. But before I get rid of it, there's something instructive you can say about that, despite my big red X there. There, I can actually get rid of it here. Is that if this happened, of course, then the Earth's its equator, which is, of course, is the line that sort of separates the Earth in two halves, light from the sun would always sort of come in and hit the equator right there. So in this situation here, if you were on Earth, like say you were a little person standing right here on Earth, you would say that the sun is always over the equator. And so that just drives directly to the heart of this question number 36 that says the sun is always over the equator, right? In this case here, then the answer to question 36 would be yes. Okay? But again, let's go back to the big red mark. This picture is not right. The Earth doesn't sit in its orbit like that, so you're not going to say the answer to question 36 is yes either. Let's just start again below and get this right. So if you go down once again, you would start by drawing a big circle representing the orbit of the Earth like this, and go ahead and put the sun right in the center. All that was right from last time. We're not wrong there, okay? And this is supposed to be a little bit of three-dimensional perspective if you want, like this. This line right here is supposed to be in the back, and this line here is supposed to be in the front a little bit like that. Let me try to give you a little perspective, like you could sort of draw this front part of the orbit here maybe a little bit thicker like this to make it sort of indicate that it's in the front like that. So it's sort of, I'm trying to draw a three-dimensional object in sort of a plane, which is hard to do. All right, but now, focus. Let's draw the Earth in there. Here's that ball, which is going to be the Earth. Definitely have that in there. Leave it blue like that. But now when we draw the axes of the Earth doesn't sit straight up and down the way I drew right here. That's not the way it works. So what we're going to do is we're going to draw the Earth the way it actually sits in the orbit, and it's tilted like this. So you draw the axis tilted, so it is true here. The Earth is tilted in its orbit. So in other words, it sits like this in the orbit with the equator down like that, not like this. So again, this is just not the right view to draw the Earth straight up and down like that. So that's sort of the problem with that first drawing that I did up there anyway, okay? So it's tilted like this, and let's get the equator in there. Here's the equator like that, looks okay. So that's sort of the way the Earth looks in its orbit. It's tilted in its orbit. I'm not about to say towards or away from the sun, we'll get to that, but that's definitely what it looks like. The tilt angle is even known. Like if I drew a dotted line with respect to the vertical like that, then this axis in here is tilted at, does anyone know? Say it yourself, 23.5 degrees. So the Earth is tilted at 23.5 degrees relative to some, say, big vertical here that might be, if you will, if this is the plane of the solar system with the sun sitting right here, this sort of reference axis would be sort of an axis that's straight up out of the sun like that, and we're drawing the Earth. This tilt might be the axis of the Earth, what you measure the axis of the Earth's tilt with respect to. So this line right here relative to this line would be where the 23.5 degrees comes from. So it's not a great drawing at the moment here, but again, that's the angle that we're talking about, 23.5 degrees for the Earth. Now, the most sort of interesting thing about the Earth as it orbits like this is it maintains this tilt as it goes through its orbit like this. So as the Earth orbits around the Sun, the tilt doesn't go away. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at four positions of the Earth in its orbit around the Sun. It'll be here, here, and here. So you can think of these here maybe as positions number one, number two, number three, and number four. And let's get the axes in there properly. So we'll just, the Earth maintains this tilt as it rotates. It looks like this, and there's the equator right there. Over here, it looks like this, and there's the equator right there. And over here, it looks like this, and there's the equator right there. So the idea of moving forward is that if you can understand what's going on with the Earth and the sunlight in all four of these positions right here, namely position one, position two, position three, and position four, you can understand the answer to some of the questions about, is the sun always over the equator? Why do we have seasons? And even the other question about, does the sun set always in the west? So we'll continue on with this orbit and the four positions of the Earth in the next video.